In this video, we are looking at how to utilize a power steering pump pulley removal tool. So this is a really basic tool, Napa, Lisle, several people make it, and it is a method for us to pull off this pulley. And oftentimes we have to do this just to even get to the mounting bolts for the pump. So here we've got a pump just in the vise. We're going to start by selecting the proper tool for removal. So I get this small tool that adapts, and it allows us to put pressure right on the center post or shaft of the pump. It's also got a threaded collar that then goes on the outside. And I'm going to get this piece here. This is going to go around the pulley itself, and it's going to grab the pulley, and the inside is threaded so that we can get that pulling effect to take this pulley off. This particular kit has this stud that we run in that also serves as kind of a handle for whenever we're ratcheting and running this down. So next I'm going to get that center post and run that in. Once I've got that in, I'm going to use hand tools to tighten it. This is a really important piece. You can use powered or pneumatic tools, but it often is just a quicker way to destroy the tool or the pulley. The feel of running this by hand is important. Whenever it starts to go, often it will have an initial pop and maybe a creak or clicking noise as it continues to move. This is a good noise. This means things are moving. If you continue to ratchet and ratchet and nothing's moving, usually that's the tool that's flexing and distorting or tearing the pulley, so we should stop and check. So as long as you see the back, you see it moving, then you can continue. Keep running it. There's always going to be some constant form of tension or resistance, and that's good. If you hit a wall where it stops, that's often bad. Something's stuck. Once you get to the end, it should just pop off. Now we can take and disassemble our tool. So we've just got to undo the clamshell that goes around the pulley, take all the other little pieces off, and get those put back into the kit. Next, we're going to look at installation of the pulley. So I've got to swap tools. I now get this pin. I'm using this pin just to check for the depth of the shaft and threads within. And I want to get one that's got a good number of threads that will fit. The more threads, the better, so that I don't risk destroying the threads within that pump shaft. So again, just a depth check. And I want to use this one because it's got quite a bit of threads versus this one is too short. And it's intended for the other side of the tool. There is another one in there that has more threads, but here you can see we're really kind of pushing the edge of getting that to fit. So we'll go with our first selection. So this is going to thread into the center of the pump shaft. We're going to run that all the way down, and it's going to leave some threads for the center post of my tool that we use for removal. Next, I'm going to slide my pulley on. Really important that I get this the right way. When you get these backwards, it is a nightmare to get them back off. So always make sure you've got it going the right way. Next, we get a bearing and then this nut that goes onto the center post. And what I'm going to do is hold the center post while rotating this nut. And that's going to push the pulley down onto the shaft and put it in place. So again, best that I do this by hand. I can usually kind of work both the outside and inside to speed things up a little bit. And nice constant pressure is always the best. Again, if you hit a wall, if it feels like it tightens up, we want to stop, we want to check what's going on and see why we hit that kind of hard spot. And in this process, I need to pay really close attention to the depth. That's something that I would have looked at prior to removal of the pulley, is to ensure I'm going to place this in the proper spot. And if I've got this installed on the vehicle still, then I can do a straight edge or a laser sight to check belt alignment. Last step here, I'm going to put all my pieces back in the kit where they go. Take note if anything was dirty or damaged, so I can fix that. I don't want to put any of that back into the toolbox. And that's the process. This process is very similar for any threaded insert style or threaded shaft, whether that be a crankshaft, a power steering pump, or any other accessory drive. This process with a puller tool is pretty similar.